So you say that a grand jury could not have been clearer in its indictment of Jesse Smollett, having only seen a sliver of the evidence. So how do you explain this truly dramatic reversal today?
I can't. It's that simple, and nor can anybody else explain it, because if it was easy to be explained, the state's attorney's office would have been out explaining it. And here's my basic anger. There is no sense from this person who now, the state's attorney said, committed the actual crime here, or actually the hoax. There's no sense of contrite, no sense of remorse. The fact is, Wolf, in this act, he not only obviously all the resources of police to investigate and get to the bottom of a alleged hate crime that turned out to be a hoax, not the financial problem, but then taking all the notions of what hate crimes and the reason we have those laws on the books is to protect people of faith, racial background, sexual orientation, that they cannot be a victim of a crime, a violent crime of any nature, because of who they are, what they believe, or how they, who they love. And he used that for his self-promotion. The state's attorney's office itself, and I accept Ms. Fox's view that she has recused herself, but the office says that he is wronged. He actually committed the crime. There is a hoax here. But then he's walking around like he's exonerated, with no sense of remorse or contrite. And he's taken that law, turned it upside down, inside out, and used it for himself. What happens to the young man who wants to, in the future, come forward because he has been a victim of a hate crime, or somebody out of a place of employment where there's actually a noose left at their desk or at their locker? They're going to be not willing to come forward because they're going to be questioned, all because of who he is, that caught everybody by surprise, and he all of a sudden gets off with 2 days of service?
So,
Wolf, I want to ask you a question.
Yeah.
You and I are both Jewish. If on your front door there was a swastika or mine, and it found out weeks later, after all the empathy, that either you or I had put that swastika on our door, we would get off with 2 days of service at the Anti-Defamation League? Really? That's what would happen here?
So why do you think the Cook County prosecutor then went ahead and dropped these charges?
I cannot answer that question. The state's attorney, the head of the state's attorney, has recused herself. I cannot answer the question for what the office
did. Did they inform you in advance that this was about to happen? Because all of us know what's been going on over these past several weeks.
No. I mean, not only did they not inform myself, the fact is, when we came off the stage after the largest police graduation and promotion, find out about what's happening here, it's, to me, makes no sense. It makes no legal sense, no common sense, and this is an abomination in my sense of justice. The notion that they say he's guilty of this hoax, he's walking around, I did nothing wrong. And you literally take in the law, and all of us who worked on getting the hate crime legislation, the Matthew Shepard legislation, passed and signed into law. Because it finally meant to the United States that the values we share, that you cannot be a victim of a crime, a violent crime to boot, because of your faith, your background, your race, or who you love. And then he used those laws and those sentiments that bind us together as a community, as a society, that say we will stand behind it. And he used it to promote his own career.
So,
and then he's walking around as if he has done nothing wrong.
Well, you clearly, Mayor,
to me,
are calling out Smollett, but Smollett didn't take responsibility because the prosecutor, the specific Cook County prosecutor, Joseph McGatz, didn't demand it in order to drop the charges. What do you have to say about this prosecutor, Joseph McGatz?
Well, I think the prosecutor's office, the office needs to explain the why. I can't do that for you, but I can speak for the people of the city of Chicago. This person, you know, the actor, used the city, came here from New York to acted like there was a crime committed. Our police went diligently. Our law enforcement worked tirelessly to uncover a hate crime and find out who perpetuated it, and we find out it's a hoax. Now, remember, and I want to get back to this, all the evidence, or not all this, a portion of the evidence, was shown to a grand jury, and they came back with all the charges. The same office that then dropped it. It makes no sense.
So was the full picture, was the full picture painted by the evidence, perhaps not as compelling as what was presented to the grand jury.
It was compelling enough. Well, wait a second. The evidence presented to the grand jury is what brought the charges.
But did new questions arise in the subsequent weeks from more evidence that might be out there?
That's not what the state's attorney just said today. They said, in fact, the police did a good job and the evidence holds up and he actually did commit the hoax. They're saying $10,000 and 2 days of community service is good enough. And I don't believe, not only is it not good enough, especially when he's walking around thinking that he is actually innocent, not guilty, and B, he's innocent not only legally in a criminal justice sense, he is also guilty, in my view, of a moral crime, which is to use the hate crimes to advance his own career for selfish reasons. And that, to me, is where there's a moral violation and a rip, because he went out and spoke on ABC to the country as an African-American and a gay man about being a victim of a crime. And then what comes forward and what we actually now know to be the case, and even the state's attorney today acknowledged, is the fact that that was all a hoax. And there's a moral violation, let alone a violation of the code of criminal justice, that here's a person who now believes with $10,000, 2 days of community service at Operation Push, the slate is clean and he did nothing wrong. In fact, his word is true. And I'm just telling you, if he was anybody else, and this is what is upsetting people in the city and around the country, he has one law or one kind of standard of accountability and everybody else gets another. And that's wrong. And the problem we're having today is everybody thinks if you're in a position of power or a position of influence, there's two rule books, one for everybody else and one for the people of influence. And this is a horrible example of if he wasn't an actor, you really think two days of community service would be enough?
The Cook County prosecutor, Joseph Begat, says the decision to drop the charges, in his words, is not all that unusual. Let me get your reaction to that.
I'm not a lawyer, thank God. I can't tell you if it's not unusual or unusual, but let me say this. If it was so usual, why is everybody acting like it's unusual? And in your own reporting leading up to this, in a bizarre turn and an unusual turn, it is not usual. This is not a pattern. The fact is, if it wasn't for the fact that he's an actor with influence and capacity to have influence, you would not get off with 2 days of community service at Operation Push. And you wouldn't get off if we found out that, or I would not get off, if you found out I put on my front door a swastika with all the symbolism of what that means to the Jewish people, and we found out for my own career I put that on the door, or you for your own career put that on, you think 2 days of community service at ADL, the slate would be clean, it would all be sealed. The other thing is, let us not forget this, Wolf. He said he wanted his day in court for all the evidence to come forward. The grand jury only heard a portion of the day. If he wanted that, as he claimed, let's have that day, let's unseal the documents, we'll go to court, and we'll see what really happened here. But the fact is, he's walking away, no remorse, no contrite, doesn't believe he did anything wrong, and he used the laws that are the hate crime laws to advance his own career, and he got caught at it, and his entire penalty back to society is 2 days of community service. It's just not right. It's not right on any level.
Mayor Rahm Emanuel, a very, very dramatic day in your city of Chicago today. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks, Wolf.